Hi, it's Alexis. Welcome to this new video. In this video, I'm going to share with you tips from FBI agents, experts in negotiation, that I quote would be talking anyone into or out of just about anything. Trust me, there are a few really interesting tips that you can apply with your ex, and I'm going to share with you these tips. But before I do, there's something you need to understand when it comes to negotiating with hostages or with your ex or with the mother, with anyone basically. You need to set a ground of trust. You need to establish rapport with your counterpart. So how do you do that? I'm going to share with you three tips, but before I do that, what you need to do is to understand the other. That's the first thing. The second thing is you need to let the other understand you understood them. And only by doing that, you will be able to establish rapport and let the other speak and share what they have in mind and get closer to you and agree on a deal and release the hostages, right? Release the dog. If you have a dog and you broke up and she kept or he kept the dog, maybe you can use that to get the dog back. And don't split the difference, because you can't split a dog. Anyway, about let's stop with the silly things. The first tip you can apply with your ex is mirroring technique, as a mirror, just the same as what's behind me, mirroring technique. It's, and they say that in the book, it's just magical. Mirroring technique. So there's mirroring in terms of body language, and there's mirroring in terms of languages. In terms of languages, mirroring, the way it works is you have to repeat, and it's very simple, it's that simple. You have to repeat the last three words of what the person says. So if he or she tells you something about, oh yeah, I like that time when we were walking at that river. Oh yeah, I remember also when we were walking near that river, because in that river it wouldn't work. Any sort of examples like that, you do that by the book, last three words. You do that again and again and again and again. And what the magical thing will happen is that the person will realize, we're sync. I feel I'm talking to a mirror, hence the mirror technique. It sounds very silly. It sounds very obvious, but that's what they use. That's what they use. That's what also psychologists, therapists used in order to establish rapport with patients and clients. That's in terms of languages. In terms of body language, it's about the posture. Try to see whether he or she puts her hand in the air, checking her phone. Try to mirror the way they move. You can test that with a friend, and you see it's just amazing how people react. It's very unconscious things that happen, but people tend to replicate the other. And when they feel the person does the same, they feel like we're the same, and therefore you start from a trust basis. You start from a place where, okay, now we are sync, now we're on the same page, I can now communicate with you. Second tip is to label emotion. Emotion is critical in crisis situation, but also in relationship, obviously. And by labeling emotion, you help your ex to understand you understood her or him. I understand you're scared of commitment. I understand you're upset about this and that. I understand you're sad about this and that. By labeling emotion, you allow the other to speak about their emotion, to speak about how they feel, and let those feelings out. Third one, very important as well, don't pressure your ex. Same in hostage negotiation. They explain that the worst thing that could happen is to let the hostage taker that feel that he's under pressure. Because by doing that, what's going to happen, they're going to take risk, and they're going to risk the lives of the hostages. Same with your ex. If she or he sees that you're putting pressure on them, they'll start to freak out. They'll start to take risks. They'll start to, or they're going to have put barriers, step back, avoid you, you know, that's going to be their reflex. Similar to when you hear a bang, reflex is to, you know, escape. Same with relationship. Don't pressure the other. Most of the time, the other need that space, need that time. Allow them to have that time and that space. If you are exchanging text and at some point he or she doesn't reply to a message for a day or two, don't pressure the other by saying, "Have you seen my text? What's going on?" It is the best way for you to damage your recovery, right? So remember, these three tips you can apply with your ex: mirroring technique, labeling emotion, and don't pressure your ex. I hope these tips were helpful. If you need to get in touch with us or learn more about how we could help you, there's a few links at the bottom of the video. It's totally free. Have a look. It's just amazing. And I hope to see you there and speak with you if you have some time. Ciao. Bye.